Okay, hello everyone. Okay, so thank you everyone. Let's start. And I'm not giving any introduction, etc. things. First, we are going to handle our new problem. And in this problem, we have to determine power displayed by resistance R. So please, everyone, tell me what will be the correct answer. Power determine resistance R. Yes, yeah, dear, everyone, tell me. Power determined by a power dissipated by this resistance R will be. Yes, everyone. Hello, yaar, Harshit. Hello, everyone. And sorry for that type of delay. Now, yes, everyone. First, read this problem carefully. What will be the approximate power dissipated by resistance R in steady state? My dear friend, here we have one uncontrolled device, and that is ideal. Now it is playing, Harshit. Now it is, I think, coming. Just recheck it. Okay, so this device is a diode. It is ideal, and that mechanical switch is also ideal. And that switch is going to close at t equal to 0. Okay, dear? The value of resistance R is 1 mega ohm and the value of C is 1 microfarad. So first, before starting this problem, my dear friend, consider this circuit. It is first order RC network. It is first order RC network. Now, everyone, please tell me what will be the value of time constant tau. What will be the value of time constant tau? Yes, everyone, please. Yes, dear. What will be the time constant? Yes, everyone tell me. Yes, now dear tell me. So the time constant for this network is nothing but tau equal to RC. Okay? And we are talking about only this section. Please mind it, my dear friend. Only for this section. We are not considering this diode and that supply to calculate this time constant. So tau is equal to RC is 1 micro into 1 mega is nothing but 1 second. It is clear? Yes, everyone. So tau equal to RC, 1 second. Now, dear, see, before starting this example, first we would try to understand what is the concept of time constant and why we require time constant here. And next, the property of diode also, and then supply. Supply is pure AC, so we can draw that supply plus minus Vm sin omega t in that fashion, and the peak value of this voltage is 400 volt and minus 400 volt. This is a thing, dear. Okay, now everyone tell me please, what will be the conduction period of diode? Conduction period of diode. Yes, everyone, please. What will be the conduction period of diode? Yes, yaar, sabhi log boliye beta. And what should be the procedure to identify the conduction period of diode. Dear C, at the cathode of diode, we have parallel combination of R and C. At the cathode of diode, we have parallel combination of R and C. The like nature of C and R will decide whether this diode will conduct or not, and that thing we can easily decide if our anode voltage of diode is greater than cathode, diode will conduct. Okay, diode will conduct until capacitor will get fully charged. Now, dear, listen to me carefully. My question is, suppose we have one diode here, and at the cathode of diode, my dear friend, we have plus minus 10 volt. Okay, and at the anode of diode, we have one variable supply. Let this is VI, variable supply. Now, everyone tell me, if this voltage VI is 9 volt, then this device will conduct or not? Yes, everyone. Then this diode will conduct or not? Yes. My dear friend, this supply anode is less than this cathode. So that diode is not off. Is not on. It will still off. Okay. Now see, my dear friend. Good, Harshit. Now see, this supply voltage is 10 volt. Now tell me everyone, this diode will on or not? This diode will on or not? Yes, everyone, yeah. Good, good. No, my dear friend, please mind it. If one diode is off, then to turn on this diode, VA voltage must be greater than VK. So an off diode can conduct when we have to satisfy this condition. Okay. Now, dear friend, see here, that is the AC supply. And that AC supply is going to deliver power to C and R through this diode D. Okay, through this diode D. In yesterday class, I told you that to calculate or find out the conduction period of any device, when we have energy storing element in load, always determine current of diode in time domain. In time domain. Or you can determine voltage across diode in time domain. If these current and voltage are positive, your device will be on, otherwise it will be off. Otherwise it will be off. Now, my dear friend, here we are assuming some voltage V0. And now we are going to discuss the nature of output voltage. Now see, my dear friend, this is the VS supply. Okay, here 0, 2 pi we can write, and pi. This is, my dear friend, maximum value Vm, which is given 400. Now see, dear, 0 to pi by 2, this device will conduct. Why? Because 0 to pi by 2, the slope of supply is positive. This supply is going to rise. So in this period, please mind it, beta. In this period, VAK of diode greater than 0. Now see, so diode is on and capacitor and one more resistor are connected across the supply. So all elements are in parallel. It means this capacitor will charge by same supply voltage. My dear friend, at omega t equals to pi by 2, this capacitor will attain, or 0 to pi by 2, this capacitor will get charged. And at omega t equals to pi by 2, this capacitor will get fully charged by Vm. Now see, my dear friend, at omega t equals to pi by 2 plus, at omega t equals to pi by 2 plus, the supply voltage slope is negative. Please mind it. The supply voltage slope is negative. If this slope is negative, it means that voltage is going to decrease. Now see, whether our capacitor is going to discharge or not, whether our capacitor is going to discharge through R or not, after pi by 2, after pi by 2. Dear, we have already calculated tau, which is nothing but 1 second. And what is supply frequency is given in example. Supply frequency Fs is 50 Hz. So time period of this complete cycle, how much? 20 millisecond. Now see, my dear friend, the time constant once this diode is open, okay, once this diode is open. So we have, this is first order RC network, which is source free, which is source free. Please mind it. It is source free. Now, dear, this is source free network. So the discharging rate of this capacitor will finalize by this time constant tau. You know very well, my dear friend, to discharge this capacitor completely, we require almost 4 tau time. That means 4 second. And 4 second time interval is very, very large in comparison to 20 millisecond. But fortunately, beta, in the range of 2 pi to 3 pi, again this supply is positive. So for a certain period, our capacitor will get charged. The moment at which capacitor voltage is just lower than the supply voltage, capacitor will start to charge and diode will conduct. We don't have sufficient time in that type of analysis because it is or that session is going for YJEC exam. But please mind it, my dear friend, in the transient period, our diode will conduct for the 0 to pi by 2. But in steady state, once it will get charged, in steady state, the conduction period of diode will almost negligible. And after that, we have our response something like this. Something like this. It is clear to all? Now, my dear friend, in steady state, if we ignore the ripples of this capacitor voltage or resistive voltage, then we can draw one straight line. And that voltage in steady state will represent by either capacitor voltage or resistor voltage. And the value of this will be 400 volt. As already given here, this is the peak value. So by peak value, our capacitor will get charged and will maintain almost 400 volt here with respect to any time. Please mind it. With respect to any time. Thank you, Harshit. Now, dear, the voltage across this R is almost constant. The voltage across this R is almost constant. So what will be the power loss due to this R? P is equal to V square by R is nothing but 400 square by, what is the value of R, dear? 1 mega. So 1 mega. Yes, please, everyone, let me know what will be the answer. Meanwhile, I am taking my calculator. Okay, just wait a moment. Yeah, just wait a moment. Yes, dear. So now tell me. Yeah, so it is coming 0.16 watt is our final answer. Is our final answer. Tell me the correct answer. Dear, listen to me carefully. I think somebody told you that YJEC exam has been postponed. Okay. So I'm not sure whether it is correct or not, but just on this chat, somebody told me. Okay. Or if like, agar nahi bhi postponed hua hai beta ji, to hume matlab isko serious lena hai. And jo bhi abhi problem aayi thi, technical issue. And मैं कोशिश करता हूं कि नेक्स्ट टाइम से ऐसा कुछ नहीं हो. सो वी कैन लर्न लॉट ऑफ गुड थिंग्स इन रिलेवेंट टाइम. ओके, सो नाउ सी, वी आर गोइंग टू हैंडल दिस क्वेश्चन. इन दिस प्रॉब्लम माय डियर फ्रेंड, इन द बिलो नेटवर्क द स्विच के इज ओपन एट टी इक्वल टू जीरो, देन डीबी बाई डी टी एट टी इक्वल टू जीरो प्लस is. Yes, please, everyone tell me, beta ji. This is 10 ampere, this is 1000 ohm, 1 farad and plus minus Vt. It is our capacitor, dear friend. See, everyone, that current source is an active device, whereas these rest two components are passive. But this capacitor can absorb and deliver energy or power. Dear friend, this switch is going to open at t equal to 0. That means earlier it is closed. It is closed. So for this network, we have two different cases. Case 1 and my dear friend, case 2. In case 1, we will handle this circuit for t less than equal to 0 negative. Or 0 minus, and case 2 for t greater than equal to 0. Now dear, if this switch is closed, see, this current will follow minimum resistance path and in this fashion it will flow. So our resistance and this capacitor will not get charged or it will not dissipate energy. So here current will be zero in this period. Period means minus infinity to zero minus. Minus infinity to zero minus. This current through this capacitor will be zero. Beta ji, if current through capacitor is zero, you know energy of capacitor Wc is half Cv square and it is equal to zero. This half and C cannot be zero at any cost. So beta ji, this V must be equal to 0 to satisfy this condition. And if V is 0, we can say capacitor behaves like short circuit. Capacitor behaves like short circuit. So here at t equal to 0 minus, we want to calculate actually initial condition. So at t equal to 0 minus, our capacitor voltage will be 0. So we can write here, my dear friend, Vc0 minus is 0. Okay. Now see, please, everyone. At t equal to 0 plus, this switch gets open circuited. Okay. This switch gets open circuited. Wait a minute, beta. Now, if this switch gets open circuited, current source is capable to deliver power to the R and C. So this circuit, because this switch is open, so this circuit now, new one, is valid for t greater than equal to 0. Okay, everyone, is valid for t greater than equal to 0. Now dear, meanwhile you can ask anything. Okay, whatever or jahan bhi aap lag karte hain beta ji, related to any topic. So t greater than something. Now, if this switch is open, that current will energize our resistor and capacitor. But we don't require that much of analysis for this question. But for better understanding, my dear friend, we require analysis. See, dear, this current source will charge this capacitor completely. If this capacitor is charged completely, let us assume at t equal to infinity, then this capacitor will behave like an open circuit. As I told you, when this voltage is constant, I through this capacitor will be zero because I is equal to C dV by dt. Now dear, this 10 ampere current will pass through this resistance only. So what will be the VC infinity? VC infinity will be 10 into 1000. Okay, so how much? 10 kV. This is the voltage. But my dear friend, he is not asking anything about VC infinity. We have just discussed this thing. He is asking dV by dt at t equal to 0 plus. My dear friend, as we discuss, VC 0 minus is 0. So VC 0 plus will also be 0. But this condition is not always true. If impulsive current passes through the capacitor, VC 0 minus is not equals to VC 0 plus. Just keep in mind, dear. Just keep in mind. So now, dear, that circuit we are going to draw at t equal to 0 plus. Okay? At t equal to 0 plus, this circuit will look like the current source 10 ampere. Our switch is open. Okay, dear? And here we have this R. And here we have capacitor. My dear friend, please mind it. Capacitor will work as a short circuit only at t equal to either 0 minus or infinity, not at t equal to 0 plus. Because at t equal to 0 plus, that capacitor can be short or it can store or deliver the energy. So it depends on the condition or the circuit in which capacitor is present. So never replace this capacitor as a short circuit at t equal to 0 plus. Please mind it, beta. T equal to 0 plus, never replace capacitor like short circuit. You can replace, but most important thing, if at t equal to 0 plus capacitor voltage is 0, you can replace it, but this time you are not supposed to do. Just wait a moment, dear. Now, my dear friend, see, this R is, I think, 1 kilo ohm, and this whatever value of C, we can take from here, 1 farad. So the value of C is 1 farad, and the initial voltage of this capacitor is 0. Now, at t equal to 0 plus, this circuit will look like something. So at t equal to 0 plus, what will be the current through this capacitor? Because it is kind of short circuit. So entire current will flow through this capacitor. Why? Because t equal to 0 plus, its voltage is 0. So short circuit, kind of. Okay? So this current will flow through this. Now see, my dear friend, at t equal to 0 plus, as I said here, at t equal to 0 plus, capacitor will be short circuit according to the circuit, not always. Okay? So now at t equal to 0 plus, this capacitor will block 0 voltage and will pass maximum current. So what will be the current through capacitor at t equal to 0 plus is 10 ampere. So let this current is IC 0 plus, which is 10 ampere. We know that, my dear friend, IC is equal to C dV by dt. So IC is equal to C dV by dt at t equal to 0 plus. And this quantity we want to determine. And that value, dear, is given 10 IC. This one we have calculated. And the value of C is 1 farad. So what will be the dV by dt? Is nothing but 10 volt per second is our final answer. Okay. Just see here. 10 volt per second. Option C is right. Okay, clear?
Yeah.
Thank you, Harshit. Now, Bitaji, we are going to discuss next example, which is related to power electronics. That is very nice. Again, example. Just read this example carefully and tell me the correct answer. Yes, everyone. Tell me the correct answer. Yes, Harshit. So 10 ampere. You explained. Okay. Thank you, Chakchit. Harshit, nice explanation. Okay, thank you. So I think there is no doubt related to anything. Yes, everyone, please tell me what will be the correct option for this question. Dear friend, read the question carefully. Okay. और जो भी बेटा जी हो आपके मन में दिमाग में जहां भी डाउट हो यू कैन आस्क एट एनी मोमेंट ओके प्लीज डोंट गेट हेजिटेट सो व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम आउटपुट वोल्टेज ऑफ थ्री फेज ब्रिज रेक्टिफायर सप्लाइड विथ लाइन वोल्टेज ऑफ 440 वोल्ट सप्लाइड ऑफ लाइन वोल्टेज ऑफ 440 वोल्ट ओके सो नाउ डियर थ्री फेज रेक्टिफायर we can draw in such a way. So this is our three phase supply. Here we required three phase bridge rectifier. So either controlled, uncontrolled, and we required six diode or six SCR. Okay. So you can use to control six SCR and for uncontrolled six diodes. And somewhere here, Betaji, we have DC output. And this DC output have number of pulses 6. Okay. So means we can say ripple frequency of this load will be 6 times of FS. This is another thing. He is not asking anything related to this thing. But just I discuss so that you can improve your knowledge. Okay. So this is the thing, dear. Now, what is the maximum output voltage of three-phase bridge rectifier supplied to the line voltage? 440. So, how much beta this? 440 volt. Yes, everyone, tell me what will be the answer. What is the maximum output voltage? Maximum output voltage. Dear, do you remember the output voltage of this rectifier will be something like this? Okay. And the time period of one cycle is how much? 60 degree. And this peak value, my dear friend, is nothing but VL max. And this is the nature of V naught. So V naught maximum value is maximum value of line voltage. And already line voltage is given. But that value, my dear friend, 440 is not a maximum. It is RMS. Whatever fashion is written here, it indicates that it is RMS value. So what will be the maximum value of V naught, my dear friend? V naught max is nothing but V line max is nothing but root 2 into V line RMS. And root 2 into V line RMS is 440. So how much final? Final will be 440 root 2. So 622.25. So 622.25 volts is our final answer. Okay, dear. Now, please, beta ji, sabhi log bataiye. Koi doubt? Aur agar nahi hai, to fir aage badhte hain. Aur hai, so let me know. Ek acha platform mila An Academy ke through, yaar. बेहतर से बेहतर डिस्कस करते हैं टेल मी एनी डाउट रिलेटेड टू पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एनी डाउट यू आर फ्री टू आस्क एनीथिंग फ्रॉम द पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एज वेल एज नेटवर्क कुछ भी पूछिए बेटा जी फ्रॉम एनी टॉपिक नॉट ओनली दिस वन गोपी कृष्णा सर विल यू बी डूइंग डीसी ट्रांजिएंट प्रॉब्लम एज वेल या फ्यू प्रॉब्लम वी विल डिस्कस डियर बट गोपी इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट रिलेटेड टू दिस थिंग प्लीज लेट मी नो ओके Just write down your problem. I will draw circuit according to your problem, and then we will handle problem according to your doubt. Okay? Yes, everyone. Any other boss? Okay, dear. Now see, we are going to discuss our next example related to transient. This is transient. In this question, my dear friend, we have to calculate current through R at time t equal to 0. Yes, everyone, tell me. Yeah, I'm waiting here. What will be the correct answer? Gopi, Harshit, Chakchit, you can also try. Sir, could you please give physical meaning of quality factor in resonant circuit in network theory? Yeah, Gopi, I will explain this thing. Okay, meanwhile, everyone, please listen to me carefully. You have to complete the solution of this problem. And in the same time period, I am giving the solution or like answer of Gopi questions. Sir, could you please this and the quality factor in resonant circuit? See, everyone, quality factor is very, very important, mainly in electronics field. Quality factor is not kind of important parameter for electrical core. Please mind it, my dear friend. A resonant term in general, we don't use in electrical core. We never studies resonant circuit in electrical machine, power system. We always studies this resonant term in a communication to tune the circuit, to operate the circuit. High frequency, please mind it. Resonant condition generally occurs at high frequency, 500, 1 kilohertz, megahertz. That frequency not available in electrical core, because generator, motor, any AC appliances, either in domestic field, in industry, including power plant also, operates only at 50 hertz. Please mind it, if somebody asks the physical meaning of quality factor in interview, never say it improves the power factor. Never say, please, in electrical core. Yeah, it can improve power factor, but at high frequency, my dear friend, at high frequency. So please listen to me carefully. To tune this circuit, electronic circuit, we require a condition at which the reactive component will cancel to each other, is called resonant condition. And at this condition, we have one voltage amplification factor or current amplification factor. This amplification factor actually called quality factor. Actually called quality factor. Okay, Gopi, it is clear to all? Now, sir, yeah, this is the thing. Now, everyone, please tell me what will be the correct answer for this question. The circuit given above is in a steady state for a long time. With switch S open, the switch is closed at t equal to 0. The current through R at t equal to 0 will be. Yes, Gopi, Harshit, anyone, please tell me. So, my dear friend, here we have two capacitor. And this switch, circuit something close at t equal to 0. So again, beta ji, we have to discuss this circuit in two different zones. First is t less than 0. Second is t greater than. Now, my dear friend, listen to me carefully. For t less than 0, this switch is open. So switch S is open. If open, now see, this active element plus minus 12 volt will deliver power in this fashion. Please mind it, beta. In this fashion. Dhyan se samajhna sabhi log. In this fashion. So this current, let us assume, beta, this is IC sum. Okay. This switch is open. So both current are equal. This IC current will charge this capacitor in this fashion or by this polarity. Why? Please mind it, beta. When any element passes current from positive to negative, any element, voltage source, current source, resistor, inductor, capacitor, anything, if current passes plus to minus, power will absorb, otherwise deliver. So here this capacitor is going to absorb power, so capacitor will charge. Similarly, this capacitor will also charge. Please mind it, my dear friend, the polarity of this capacitor voltage cannot change suddenly. Dhyan se samajhte rehna beta ji har point ko. The polarity of this capacitor voltage cannot change suddenly. And the charging magnitude of this capacitor we can calculate easily by KCL, KBL or Ohm's law. Now this active element will charge over this inductor and capacitor, and some amount of energy will dissipate into resistor. All these things we have to discuss here. My dear friend, at t equal to 0 minus, theoretically, wording ko mere catch kiya karo beta, theoretically, not practically, theoretically, this and that capacitor and this inductor will attain steady state or will reach into steady state. In steady state, if inductor charge, dhyan se sabjo sabdo ko beta, in steady state, if inductor charge, then short circuit. In steady state, if inductor uncharged, then open circuit. In steady state, if capacitor charged, open. In steady state, if capacitor uncharged, short. So it depends. Never say in steady state capacitor like open. Please ask to that person whether he is asking steady state condition of capacitor with charging or uncharging. If he is asking with charging, then open, and if like discharge or completely uncharged kind of, then it will be short. So steady state will decide by the circuit situation. Now my dear friend, here this current will pass, so this inductor will charge, and t equal to 0 minus, this inductor will be short and this capacitor will be open. Okay, dear. Now tell me, till now any doubt? Okay. So 2 by 3 ampere. Okay, dear. Now, my dear friend, see, at t equal to 0 minus, no current will flow through this capacitor. So 0, entire current will flow through this inductor. How much resistance, my dear friend? 10 into 12. So 12 by 12 is 1. So how much current here? 1 ampere. So VC1, I'm saying this is 1, okay? This is C1, that one is C2. So VC1, 0 minus is how much? 1 is na. So wait a minute, 1 and 2. Wait a minute, beta. IL0 minus is how much? IL0 minus is 12 by 12. So 1 ampere. And how much this total voltage? Total voltage is nothing but parallel across this or across it. So 2 into 1, 2 volt. So this total voltage is 2 volt. So VC10 minus will be voltage division rule. Okay. We can write here 2 into, not same capacitor, opposite capacitor, 6 divided by 6 plus 3, 9. This is the value of VC1. And VC2 will be similarly 2 into 6 divided by 9. So by this approach we can calculate VC10 minus and VC20 minus. Now dear, he is asking current at t equal to 0 or 0 plus. Okay, both are same thing here. At t equal to 0 plus, that switch will be closed. So now my dear friend, we have to draw this circuit at t equal to 0 plus also. So 10, 2, this inductor will work as a current source, and the value of this current source is how much? 1 ampere equal to this value. Then beta, this capacitor is charged by that voltage 2 into 6, so 12 by 9, and 12 by 9 is 1.33. Yeah, so this is 1.33 volts. And another capacitor is already charged by this voltage 2 into 6. So wait a minute, something is missing. Yeah, 2 into not 6, 2 into 3. So 6 by 9 is 0.667, and the addition of both voltage must be equal to 2 volts. So this is the thing, and that switch is closed. So this is 10 ohm, 2 ohm, and here we have voltage supply 12 volt. Now, my dear friend, I'm not going to handle this circuit entire. You have to find out the current through R, this R, okay? This R, at t equal to 0 plus. So you can easily find out this current IS. Now, it is very simple circuit. You can handle by KCL or KVL, okay? So, yeah, 2 into VCT, yeah, 2 into 3 by 9. Yeah, so 6 by 9. Yes, beta ji. 2 into 3. Okay, everyone. So this is a thing, dear. Now, you have to calculate this current. So with respect to ground, here you can identify this total voltage is how much. So sorry, this is 2 volt. Addition of both. So 2 volt. And 10 minus 2 is 10. So 10 by 10 is 1. So how much answer? 1 ampere. It is clear? Answer is 1 ampere. Please mind it. I think this current we have to calculate here. This current we have to calculate at t equal to 0 plus. So at t equal to 0 plus, with respect to ground, how much voltage here? 2 volts. So voltage is 2. And from here, 12. So 12 minus 2, 10. And 10 by 10 is how much? 1 ampere. So final answer is 1 ampere, if my calculation is right. Okay, dear? Now, Betaji, we are going to discuss our next example. In a single phase full wave control rectifier. Everyone, read this question carefully and tell me the correct answer. Yes, everyone. Okay. And if you like this session, then please subscribe and like this session also. Okay. So that your friends can also benefit it. Tabhi ko fayda mil paye. Aur behtar se behtar, jyada se jyada apne dost aur friend circle mein cheezon ko discuss karte raha kariye. Chai peene gaye discuss kiya, aage gaye discuss kiya. Thoda sa time pass na kijiye beta ji. Yes, everyone, tell me the correct answer. Yes, Harshit, B. In single phase full wave, Harshit, good, yaar, you are replying very nicely. In a single phase full wave control rectifier, something, minimum output voltage and maximum output voltage are obtained at which conduction angle? Okay, this is the thing. My dear friend, see, in a single phase full wave controlled bridge rectifier. Now, dear, circuit is not given. So we should take a standard circuit, okay? A standard circuit of it controlled. So we required 4 SCR. And now, my dear friend, I'm not sure whether this question is properly right or not, okay? Because it depends. Here we have some resistive element, supply voltage, sinusoidal. And these all devices are SCR. Okay. Now he's asking single phase full wave controlled bridge rectifier. Minimum output voltage and maximum output voltage are obtained at which conduction angle? Now see, my dear friend. If this load is pure resistive. Dhyan dena beta baaton pe. If this load is pure resistive and firing angle of each SCR is alpha, then V naught average will be 2Vm by, wait a minute, 1 plus cos alpha. Wait a minute, dear. Yeah, this is 2Vm by pi. So 2vm by pi 1 plus cos alpha, put alpha equal to 0, not this one. So vm by pi. I think this is the formula. For single phase full wave control rectifier, for single phase full wave control rectifier, vm by pi 1 plus cos alpha. If you put alpha equal to 0, then cos 0 is 1. So 1 plus 1, 2vm by pi is right. Now, beta, if this current is constant or continuous, please mind it, not pure resistive. If this current is continuous or constant, that means RL or RLE load. In that case, we have formula 2vm by pi cos alpha. So for this circuit, we have two different formula. Dhyan dena beta har baat pe. Two different formula. Now, if we put alpha equal to 0 here, it will give maximum voltage. He is asking minimum output voltage and maximum. Please mind it, beta. In this equation, first equation, please mind. If we put alpha 0, then max. And alpha 180, alpha 180, then minimum. Okay. So, cos 180, you can put here. So, 1 minus 1, I think. So, 0, it will be 0. Now, beta, what about this thing? If we put alpha 0, it will be similar to that value, I think. So, 2vm by pi. So, at alpha 0, it is maximum. But when alpha negative, okay. Sorry, alpha is 180. That cos 180 is negative. So, minus 2vm by pi in that case. Minus 2vm by pi. Okay, dear. So, according to these equation, we can tick our option. But my dear friend, generally average output voltage will not come negative. It can be negative only when we are using our converter in electrical braking mode. In electrical braking mode. But he is not talking anything about electrical braking mode. So we can consider this first formula, and according to this formula, we can reply our answer. It is clear, dear? We can reply our answer. Okay, dear. Now we are going to discuss the next problem. Okay. Firing angle thyristor is to controlled in the range of. Yes, everyone. Controlled. So after controlled, actually on screen you can watch up to controlled. So I'm going to write controlled in the range of. In a thyristor controlled rectifier, the firing angle of thyristor is to be controlled in the range of. Yes, tell me everyone, what will be the correct? Sir, in steady state, capacitor is open circuit only for DC or both AC and DC, sir. Okay, Gopi. Everyone, please listen to me carefully, dear friend. So, Gopi is asking, please mind it, beta. Gopi is asking, in steady state, or someone is asking, ek hi baat hai. In steady state, capacitor will be open circuit. I am saying that is absolutely wrong. Okay. Why? How can you say without any information that capacitor will be open? Suppose, beta, we have one capacitor C here, which is initially charged by some volt and connected across some R. Now tell me steady state voltage of this capacitor. Everyone, please. Steady state voltage of this capacitor. Yes, everyone, in this circuit. Initially, this capacitor is charged. Suppose charge by 10 volt. Now, steady state voltage of this capacitor. Yes, everyone, please. Gopi also. Yeah, during charging. So, in a steady state, here capacitor short. Okay, beta. But if we have a circuit in this fashion, RC plus minus this VS, then this capacitor will be open. So, first most important thing, don't say directly either it will be short or open. Circuit will decide. Now, one more one more important thing. Please mind it, Betaji, inductor and capacitor. Inductor and capacitor can behave like short or open only in DC circuit, not in AC circuit. Please mind it. Why not in AC? Because beta, once inductor or capacitor charge in AC circuit, after that moment, they will automatically or naturally discharge because sustained oscillation we required in AC. What is the meaning of sustained oscillation? Dear, sustained oscillation means the rising slope will be equal to, in general, decaying slope or discharging slope. So that thing will happen up to infinity. Due to that thing, we never achieve a condition at which our capacitor or inductor will completely either short or open. Okay, this is the thing. Now dear, tell me the answer for this question, please. Everyone, tell me the answer for this question. Please do it fast. In thyristor control rectifier, the firing angle of thyristor is to be controlled in the range of, or agar aapko acha lag raha hai beta ji, then please like and share this session also. दोस्तों को भी बोलिए थोड़ा सा इसको एंटरटेन करें चीजों को. यस थैंक यू सर. वन मोर डाउट, व्हाई डू वी वेल कॉल कैपेसिटर एज ए पैसिव एलिमेंट व्हेन द कैपेसिटर कैन डिस्चार्ज एंड सप्लाई एनर्जी सोर्स इन द सर्किट लाइक दिस. ओके, वी विल डिस्कस गोपी, जस्ट वेट अ मोमेंट. नाउ डियर, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू कंप्लीट दिस एग्जाम्पल. इन ए थायरिस्टर कंट्रोल रेक्टिफायर द फायरिंग एंगल ऑफ थायरिस्टर इज टू बी कंट्रोल्ड इन द रेंज. Dear, any SCR we can control in the range of alpha to, suppose I say some theta. The alpha is the angle at which this SCR is just forward bias. Please mind it. Alpha, the minimum value of alpha, not always zero. Please mind it, Betaji. The minimum value of alpha is not always zero. For example, we have one SCR in this circuit. Now tell me, can we trigger this SCR at alpha equal to 0 in this circuit? This is R, that one is E. My dear friend, obviously not. We can't trigger. Why? Because the value of E beta. So the moment at which this anode voltage is greater than cathode voltage, we can trigger our SCR. So here alpha cannot be equal to 0. We require some value. So this alpha is the minimum value sometimes at which our SCR is just forward bias. So minimum possible value of alpha can define the moment at which SCR will be just forward bias. And beta, maximum kya ho sakta hai? Maximum wo range jahan tak SCR forward bias rehta hai. So please never say 0 to 180 degree. Never say 0 to 180 degree. Never say 90 to 180 degree. ये पूछने वाले के तरीके होते हैं, इसलिए ऑप्शन दे दिए हैं कि बेस्ट चॉइस कर लो. अदरवाइज बेटा, अगर ये ऑप्शन नहीं दिए जाए तो आप इस टाइप के क्वेश्चन डिजाइन करने वाले बंदे पे क्लेम भी कर सकते हैं. ओके, बट ऑप्शन दे दिए इसलिए कुछ नहीं कर सकते बेटा. सो नाउ वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट बेस्ट रेंज. बेस्ट रेंज इज 0 to 180 degree. Now tell me, कौन फायर करता है यार 180 degree पे? 180 degree के बाद in general आपके पास कोई input होगा ही नहीं, almost half rectifiers में. So that is the thing beta, but this is the maximum limit. 90 to 180 is also right. 90 to 70 something is also right. But he is asking a range. So we have to consider minimum to maximum. So that's why option B is right. It is clear, dear? Yeah, thank you everyone. Now, Gopi, and everyone listen to me carefully, dear. Gopi is asking, beta, inductor and capacitor can deliver energy or power in terms of what? Then why they are passive? My dear friend, an inductor we can replace by a practical coil also, some L and R, and it will define some time constant L by R. The value of it will be second. Generally, this L is a very low value in terms of millimicro. This R is also small. So this time constant generally will be in terms of millisecond or microsecond. It is clear, beta? So inductor and capacitor can work as a source, real source that means, but not for a very long time interval. They can work as a source for a very short time interval. Due to this short time interval, they are called passive. Please mind it. They are called passive. Whereas voltage source and current source can deliver power for long time interval. Long time interval. Please mind it, beta. That's why they are called active. This is the main reason behind this. So, hope so. It is clear to all. And thank you for this session. Aap log aaye aur kuch sikha, kuch sikhaya bhi. And tomorrow at 8 p.m. at the same timing we will meet. And we have another session also tomorrow at 2 in between 2 to 3 p.m. I will update. Okay, thank you everyone. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay, but still they are delivering energy, sir. Anything that delivers energy is active, right, sir? Gopi, it is not right. Whatever element are going to deliver energy will always be active. It is not right. Okay, it depends upon the circuit situation. If the energy delivering element is going to deliver energy for a long time or considerable time, then it will be active. And we have a different region also to define active and passive, or different terms also to define active and passive. Okay, but we can't discuss that much of detail here. Okay, but just roughly you can keep in mind the time constant is the main thing behind the inductor, capacitor and voltage current source. So this time constant basically divides voltage source and current source into active and inductor and capacitor into passive. Okay, so see, wherever we want to operate, or whenever we want to operate our circuit for a very small time interval, generally we prefer inductor and capacitor as a source. But when we want to operate our system for a long time interval, we have to select voltage source or batteries to operate. This is the thing. Okay, dear. So it is, I think, clear. And still, if you have any doubt, please, you can WhatsApp me on my number. Number is already mentioned on the screen. 9891706459. And I have to stop this session here, my dear friend. So good night, everyone. Okay, thank you.